twins from South Korea. We gather together sharing the world using love to help other people. On very dark nights without a single light source, we are sometimes not able to find our ways. The fear that comes from not being able to see. It is a fear we cannot even imagine. Wouldn't blind people have more difficulties in urgent situations? A terrible disaster occurred in Korea last year that led many people to sorrow. It was the sinking of the Silver Ferry. The big cruise ship sank into the ocean just like the Korean cruise ship was stuck in Korea at the age of 2002. It was a sad accident that occurred on April 16, 2002, at the southwest of Korea. Last year, we displayed the lightbulb that moves automatically by using map diffuse at the robot creating contest that was held in Korea. It was that lightbulb that gave us the opportunity to participate in the World Robofest today. However, we came across the idea that a robot would evolve into an entirely new one if we applied the idea of humming the blind to the original robot. This came here is the core RoboExplorers for people with impaired vision. This will come in handy not only for blind people, but also for those with normal vision at accident sites. On those shoulders of the fest are small vibrating motors. These motors direct the direction to go. The motors command the direction in which the life fest should go. Smartly, the motor on the front and back directs the vest to go forwards and backwards. The software uses magnetic fields to check whether terminal points are correctly set. Here we'll demonstrate how this device can find terminal points with our eyes covered.
Send that to the satellite for post-processing.
So, the fish is made out of foam board, which is lightweight and durable. Yeah.
send it a message from the IR sensor, it will start moving. So the two circles here imitate the natural spin motion of a fish. It's controlled by an Arduino Mega over here, and it's two IR sensors that can detect the left and right of it.
The physical feature of my crab is it has 8 servos, and Arduino Mega synchronizes it all in order to walk. It can walk freely with this ultrasonic sensor, and the Arduino is an Arduino Uno that has an XP, so it can communicate with the different bots. And key features of the Aquabot is that it is made out of a couple of recycled bottles, making it environmentally friendly. It has an Arduino Uno microcontroller. It has 2 motors, 1 DC motor to control the propeller, and 1 servo motor to control the rudder. And it has 4 sensors. It has an ultrasonic sensor in the front to avoid collisions. It has a compass, it has a gyroscope, and a magnetometer.
So if I flash a light at the LDR, I'll send that XP message over to the crab to let it start moving.
So the Aquabot, when it sees the walls of the pool, using the ultrasonic sensor, it can detect when to stop and back up. And using the rudder, using the servo motor to control the rudder, it can turn the servo motor 90 degrees to the left, so it can move to the other direction and avoid collisions with like a wall or an obstacle.
Hello, KTV team from South Korea. I am Taewonam. This is Jaebin Lee. This is Jeongun Son. We'll show you our robot's functions by small situation.
3, 2, 1, time's up. So many restrooms, it's too much work.
Are you having a hard time to keep it clean? This pinbot will help you.
What is the pinbot?
Pinbot is a cleaning robot that can clean the washbowls, urinals, and toilets in public restrooms automatically.
How can a robot find a way to a toilet and make it clean?
The cleanbot finds a way by following the magnetic track under the pad. It can make very accurate moving by using 7 magnetic tracking sensors. The old robot they used to find a way by following a black strip on the floor had many problems. The floor has to be painted black and white and must be clean. But this new robot uses a magnetic track under the floor, so it is not noticeable, and it doesn't matter if the floor is clean or not. And it also has 2 encoder motors on each side to find even without the magnetic track.
Oh, I see how it moves, how it can clean the toilet.
Do you see the clean bus?
Yes.
A clean bus covers an object to clean with the clean bus. The clean bus has silicone molding on each edge so water will not splash around. Inside of the clean bus, clean bus spray hot water first, let the dirt soak and spray to detergent. Using 2 small pumps to spray water and detergents, and the servo motor helps to spray the different positions. And then, fan on the top blow air the different positions by using a servo motor and make it dry.
Wow, it's really great. The cleanbot can do all the work, but what if there is a person using a toilet?
The cleanbot has an infrared sensor on its side to find out there is a person inside. When a person locks the door, it will make a white mark, which means there is a person inside. As the cleanbot detects the white mark, it will watch the next empty spot.
If cleanbot detects any objects in front, it will start moving and speak out, "Beep beep, I'm cleaning, watch out!"
What a wonderful machine. Does it have other features?
It does. The cleanbot can clean the floors and the walls too. It also can vacuum the floor and wipe the floor attached to 2 DC motors.
As it moves along the wall, it can clean the wall with a rag attaching to a DC motors on each side.
Wow, the cleanbot can do all the work, so I don't have to do anything, right?
Oh, you still have things to do. You need to stock the toilet papers, take care of equipment in the restrooms, and all other things that a robot cannot do. But this cleanbot does all the hard work, so this will make it easy.
Very good. The restrooms in our park will be the cleanest in the city.
Let's see how this cleanbot moves. The cleanbot is moving by following the magnetic track. After it enters the restroom, it starts to vacuum and mop the floor. The infrared sensor checks if there are any toilet turning use, and then it enters to the empty toilet booth.
It covers the toilet seat with the cables and screening with hot water and detergent. To give some time to soak the dirt, it'll have some waiting periods during the cleaning process. After the cleaning and drying, it'll start the cleaning the wall. The cleaner will clean the wall for renewals by this same process.
It moves along the wall to right, rotate and clean the wall. As you can see, the cleaning is easy and effective. What do you think? Don't you want to see this clean body in the market soon? We will end the presentation here. When we started to design this robot, we tried to install the vacuum to collect the dirty water after the cleaning. But the result wasn't that successful and we had to change our plan. So we are using a small vacuum cleaner.
We have to design the machine to stand a few inches up from the floor because we need the space on the bottom to water flow away. We took the machine apart and pieces to fly up out of Korea and reassembled them together after we got here.
The cleaner is supposed to be bigger than the toilet seat. Please understand that it is only a simple cleaner to fit in the robot at this clinic. It is for showing you how it works.
Thank you for listening.
So our goal for this year was to build a robotic arm that would mimic the motions of the human hand. This is so that in an industrial setting, you can be used to move things on and off of a conveyor belt, and in an agricultural setting, it can pick fruit off of trees, and the part we like most, or what we designed the hand for specifically, is a prosthetic. It can, if you have a problem with your limb, and you can still control a guide user interface, you can control the hand and you can have a working hand. So it works for four linear actuators on the four fingers, direct drive motor for the thumb, geared down DC motors for the one for the wrist, two for the elbow, and also linear actuators will be for the shoulder motor. And this is just how the hand moves, picks up, and drops. So now Jonathan will explain the code.
So to program our robot this year, we used a combination of MATLAB and Simulink. The MATLAB here is the GUI, which will send a message to the Simulink file here, and which will be sent to the Arduino to control the motors. So it works by, when you press a button here, it'll send either 1, 2, or 0. 1 being forward, 2 being backwards, and 0 being stop. It'll send that to the Simulink file, and it'll convert it into an integer, which the Arduino can read and send to the motors. Now Christian will explain the sensors.
So the sensors form an integral part of this entire project. On the arm, we have sensors that will protect the fingers from damaging itself or the object. The pressure sensors on the fingers on the arm protect the fingers from being crushed by expending way too much force on an object that's really rigid. The flex sensors on the arm allow us to see how much the fingers have flexed or moved. We also have flex sensors on the glove. The flex sensors on the glove form a different purpose. When a hand is inserted into the glove and you move your finger, the changing position of the flex sensor adds stress to it. When stress is added to the flex sensor, its resistance changes. Putting this resistance through a voltage divider results in a changing voltage. We can then use this changing voltage in our Simulink files to find out how much we have to have the fingers move. So basically, anyone controlling the glove can control the fingers on the arm. These sensors also mimic a natural skin receptor found in the human skin, which is called the Pacinian deep receptor. Both work by having an electrode that is bent. Both work by having a shell which is exposed to stress. The only difference is how the bending of the sensors work. In a Pacinian deep receptor, the myelin sheath, the myelin neuron in the cell, changes its structure, which then releases ions, which creates an action potential. In a normal human, in a sensor, the two electrodes will bend, which then causes a changing resistance.